it's a dream come true moment, no doubt. But at the same time, the other feeling is pressure is a privilege. Like we saw, we were actually humbled and overwhelmed by the response when we saw the entire startup ecosystem get excited. All of India was excited. Initially, sometimes people ask me, hey, you're running Freshworks, you've started Together Fund, and you're doing SaaS Boomi, like why are you doing different things, right? And I think in my mind, and I haven't had enough opportunity to clarify it, but in my mind, it's always been the same thing, like the dream of India as a product nation. So my role as CEO of Freshworks gave me the opportunity to actually be in pole position, if you can use that term. What that really means is we made more mistakes than anybody else because we were learning by doing. And then what we wanted to do is how do we like share on that knowledge or pass that knowledge on to other younger founders so that they can accomplish what we accomplished sooner, right? So that's SaaS Boomi. And then Together Fund is an $85 million venture capital fund that we actually promoted. Is again to like SaaS Boomi is how do we do a conference where there are 500, 800 people, but Together Fund is how can we find those 20, 30, what we call as Olympic champions from India. And I'm a product manager at heart, right? And I think one of my earlier bosses, Kumar Vembu, actually spotted or gave me that opportunity. I did not know that I was a product manager, but he said, Girish, you are an authoritative person and you should not be in marketing. Why don't you try being a product manager? What is the role of a product person, right? So you have to understand customer problems. That's one part of it. You also have to come up with creative solutions and in the software world, you have to design those solutions. So the solutioning is another crucial part of it. I really enjoy that. And I think I love working with designers. In fact, throughout my career, I've been fortunate to work with some amazing designers. And in fact, that's what differentiates Freshworks. If you really look at each category that we play in, right, whether it's customer service help desk or IT service desk or CRM, these are very competitive categories. So there were 600 help desks when we started Freshdesk, right? But how can we enter into a crowded market and win? Because we take inspiration from what Steve Jobs said, right? Don't build features, like focus on designing the products for the end user. Our whole secret sauce, if I can call it that, in Freshworks is like, how do we really design the product to solve for the frontline user's pain and also make the product make the user get value from the product quickly. A company may buy the software today, but they may have to implement it for 12 months or 18 months and then they go live, right? So we wanted to kind of, if you buy something today, it's like instant gratification. You want to use it tomorrow. So that is how we designed our products, not just for delighting the frontline user, but also design it for rapid go live. Like how can you start using it immediately? And that's what differentiates Freshworks products. And we take a lot of conscious effort into making sure design plays a critical role there. It ties very closely with our business model. See, when Freshworks started in Chennai, our only business model was online product-led growth. So which means prospective customers are coming on the website and they are searching on Google and they land on our website and they're trialing the software. If the software is, if they don't like it, they'll close the browser tab, right? If it seems confusing, they'll close the browser tab and go. So our strength comes from our understanding of this online buyer. And we know that if we are not able to create that moment of wow and give that feeling that, hey, it seems easy, it's usable, I can use it on my, I can do it on my own, only then we win. We operate Freshworks with the spirit of Kudumba or family. And our culture code can be explained in a simple acronym called CHAT, where C is for craftsmanship, H is for happy work environment, A is for agility with accountability, and T is for being a true friend of the customer. In the early years, we had an initiative called CEO on Support, where we wanted to encourage every CEO to really talk to customers, to understand the customer world. As you become a CEO, you will realize that most people don't come and tell you the bad things, right? Like your team members will want to tell you all the good stuff and they want to assure you that everything's okay. I call the conversations with customers as a reality check. I love talking to customers because I love living in the problem domain. So only if you understand the problem domain well, you'll be able to solution. If you understand the problem domain, you understand how critical it is for this customer, but at the same time, you cannot change the behavior because it will break all the other customers. So, but how can you come up with a solution that works for this customer? The more important lesson there for all product managers is respect the customer problem, ignore the suggested solution. I think I appreciate a good product and good design. So fundamentally, whether it's a car or a watch or any electronics for that matter, I think I get excited when I see good design. And I think it's called, like, this is what we call at Freshworks as craftsmanship. I get excited when I see the attention to detail. When somebody pays attention to detail, when there is enough craftsmanship, it excites me that I want to experience that, right? So I think that's what I look for. And sometimes after a few uses, maybe some products may disappoint, but that doesn't take away the excitement of wanting to continue to look and keep buying. The Neo is the name of our Shih Tzu. So it comes from the inspired by the movie Matrix, where Neo is the chosen one. So I think like our life inside our family changed completely once we got Neo. I'll tell you an interesting anecdote. When I was doing the roadshow, I was meeting so many investors. Our platform is also called Neo, by the way, the Freshworks platform. So every time I talk about Neo, he'll just think I'm calling him and he'll look at me. I think what I truly believe is every family should actually enjoy a pet, because it truly brings out, it's a great stress buster. We can't imagine life without Neo. For me, I've always talked about work-life integration as opposed to work-life balance, right? So I am a believer that you don't have to have a 40-hour work life where you just earn money and then go and live life separately. So I always believe that, okay, work should be fun, life should be fun, and you should be like able to choose. This is what I tell my son. So like my elder one is ready to go to college. So I tell him, like, pick what you like. Like my son likes design and art. So I'm telling him, like, be a craftsperson. Like, whatever you're doing in your class, can you be the best in that? Like, you go above and beyond and pay attention to the detail. The curiosity to learn is important. That's my message to my boys. If you can move from a state of I don't know to I really know, because you had the curiosity to learn, that will serve you for the rest of your life. Sport teaches you life lessons, right? See, I think in India specifically, we value education more than sport. And that is because parents are well-wishers. They want their children to get into a good job and not suffer in life. And that is fine. Parents being well-wishers is fine. But what most of us don't understand is sport teaches you life skills. Like, for example, I'll tell you, when I hire somebody, if they've played a team sport, I would love to hire that person, because you know how to play in a team. That's a very important life lesson in any company, right? You don't want brilliant jerks. And that, we have said that, like, I don't, like, even if you're brilliant, don't be a brilliant jerk, right? So, because I think the days of the individual star in a company are gone. Like, you need, everybody has to be part of a team. And I think just at a very simple level, sport is a great educator in terms of playing to your strength, understanding the weaknesses of your team members, how to come up with strategy, how to execute. I know that not everybody can actually learn well in a classroom setting. So I think we are letting our champions fail by forcing everybody to go into that classroom setting, right? So we have to create the avenue for our champions to actually excel. We have all the talent. We have not invested in the right infrastructure, and we have not invested in the right training. I hope I can inspire more people to start helping sports people around the world. Like FC Madras is an initiative that we'll probably talk about sometime next year. But I really hope like hundreds of people get inspired and they all start investing in infrastructure. I like to be a student for life. So I'm almost learning with a vengeance. So I look at this journey of Freshworks and everything that I'm doing as a huge learning journey. The other word I can tell you is I like to be the perennial underdog. right? So I like to be the underdog. So I think punching above our weight and winning against tougher competition. So I think underdog and student for life.